Hello everyone, in this video we will see how to apply a design on a dress using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and as you can see I have the model that we'll be using with a dress mock-up, which is just a white dress. And in here we have the design or the pattern that we'll be applying in here. And I already went ahead and cut the dress alone, as you can see, just a simple cutting. So we won't waste a lot of time doing that. Now, this should be a very straightforward tutorial. But the different thing about this is we're not gonna use any displacement map or anything. So we're gonna try to actually apply the design using the shadows that we already have in the dress, and we're gonna apply it and we'll make it look as realistic as possible. Alright, so the first thing that of course we want to do is actually to apply the design in the dress cutout in here. So, but before we're gonna do that, I'm just gonna select my pattern and I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T. And I will make it smaller to fit only the area where the dress is, somewhere around here. Let's see. Yeah, something like that. Maybe make it a little bit go with the proportion. Yeah, something. I'm doing this by pressing Alt or Option on my keyboard, and this will allow me to play with the scaling of this. Alright, something like that, and a little bit in this side, and a little bit right here. Alright, so this should be good to go. Maybe I will keep it like that, and I will want to click on this check mark. Alright, now I'm gonna put this back to 100%, and then I will right click and convert this to Smart Object. And then I'm gonna clip it, so I'm just gonna right click again and create clipping mask, and this will clip it to the layer underneath, which is the dress. As you can see now, it's not something realistic or anything, but if we change the blending mode to multiply, you can see a little bit of the shadows, but we need to emphasize these things even more for it to be looking good. And to do that, we're gonna open the blending option by selecting the pattern design and go into this FX icon, and I will choose blending options. Next, I will play in the blend if area where it said underlying layer. Let's go ahead and actually split this shadows area by pressing Alt or Option with one click, and this will allow me to split it. And if you notice, you can see like there are some shadows in here that's appearing more. So this is before and after, especially in the hand. You can see it's blending much better. And then we will go to the light source, and then we're gonna again pressing Alt or Option, and I will split this. And as you can see, it will adapt the light that it's underneath, which is the dress. But as you can see, it's too much light. So I'm just gonna keep it from 255 to 225, or maybe 230. And the rip is okay for now. All right, so to fix this exposure that we have in here, we need less exposure. And to do that, gonna apply an exposure adjustment layer. So I'm just gonna select the dress and go to this adjustments icon, and I will go to exposure, and then in this exposure I'm gonna put -0.12, just a little bit for it not to lose all the lights that we have, something like that. I think it will look good. And then I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to multiply, and I will drop down the opacity a little bit to 50%. Alright, now I think it's much, much better, as you can see. Alright, but still we need to make it look more realistic as possible. So, there is a trick that I like to do. But before we're gonna do that, actually, I want to apply a little bit of blur in the edges in here. And that's why I changed the design to a smart object, so I can go ahead and do that. So to do that, I will go to filter, and I will go to blur and I will apply Gaussian blur. And I will keep the blur set to 2 pixels and I will press OK. And then I'm gonna select this smart filter and I'm gonna reverse it by pressing Ctrl or Command I on my keyboard, and this will change it to black layer mask. And then I'm gonna switch to my brush by pressing B on my keyboard and using white as my foreground color. I'm gonna start painting a little bit in the edge to make it a little bit blur, but not that much, maybe just a little bit. Maybe I will even put the opacity to 60%, and I will just paint in the edge to blend more with the background that we have. Alright, now it should be blending much better. As you can see, this is before and after. It looks much better. Next, actually I want to have a copy of this dress. So I'm gonna select the dress layer and then I'm gonna press Alt or Option on my keyboard, and I will one click while I'm pressing Alt or Option. I will one click and drag and put it on top, and this will allow me to make a copy of it. And then I will right click on this layer mask and I will choose Apply Layer Mask, because I don't want the whole image, I only want the dress. As you can see, now this dress, actually we're gonna play with it to have only the shadows that we have in here, but before we're gonna do that, I'm gonna make sure to desaturate it, because sometimes you will find some hidden colors. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Shift U or Command Shift U on my keyboard, and this will desaturate it. And then I'm gonna apply level adjustment. So I will go to Image, Adjustment, and I will choose Levels, and I will make it dark quite a bit, as you can see, and I will press OK. Alright, so we won't leave it like this. We will actually, again, we'll go to the blending options. So while I'm selecting the copy of the dress, I will go to this FX icon and I will choose blending options. And let me zoom out a little bit. Now we want to actually play with the blend if, but I want only to use this layer, not the underlying layer. So let's first actually move this white point in here and let's see what happened. As you can see, when I do that, all the white disappear, but it doesn't disappear in a smooth way, so we need to split it. So I'm gonna press Alt or Option again and I would one click and split this, and now we have a smooth transition, and I will press OK. Now we only have the shadows area applied, but it's a little bit rough and it has noise. So to eliminate a little bit of the noise, I'm gonna apply a blur. So I will go to Filter, Blur, and choose Gaussian Blur, and I would keep the blur set to 2 pixels and I will press OK. Alright, now we're gonna change the blending mode of this to Multiply, and as you can see, it will emphasize the shadow area, but it's a little bit too strong, so I'm just gonna drop down the opacity to like 50%, and I'm gonna clip it to the other layer that we have, the original dress. So I'm just gonna press Alt or Option and one click in between, and this will clip it. And there we go, let's see the before and after. So this is before and this is after, and that will be all. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment any new words for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.